Welcome back to Media Day Live. We're in the beautiful suites here of M&T Bank Stadium, home of the Baltimore Ravens. And we have an expanded set this year, obviously, from years before. We're beginning with the New Hampshire Wildcats. We have head coach Sean McDonald right here, Trayvon Bryant, and we have Jawan Horton over here to our left. And coach, we're going to start with you. Obviously, it's a redundant question every single year. 14 straight season, going for 15 to the FCS playoffs. How do you do it?
First, start with good people. And I got two great kids here that are there. You got great coaches. We've been able to refocus every year, Bobby, and I think that's the key thing. You know, everybody's talking about legacies and stuff like that. When we get back in August 1st, we just, put it on the board. What's the next one? How we got to do it? Got to go about it that way and understand that you're setting your standard for your program that day, starting August 1st, for what we're going to do. And our kids have bought into that, and that's a credit to the coaches who have recruited them and the guys that are playing for us.
How important is that? I mean, when you recruit someone to come to New Hampshire, that you're getting the right kind of kid to be able to do it as long as you have, you've got to have kind of a target that you're looking for.
You know, it's a feel, and it's a lot of different ways. You've got to trust a lot of people in the process. Right. And I think the most important people you got to trust are the kids and the parents that you're recruiting. You got to find out, from day one, what their interests are, how they go about doing their business. And the next thing is that you've got to explain to them how we do it,
right.
And you're hearing all these things about culture and the process and stuff like that. To me, it's about an opportunity to get the most important thing. You're going to get a degree, and then the next opportunity to play some great football in the best league in the country.
Jawan, let's talk a little X's and O's. Defense returns 9 starters this year, fully loaded defense. What are some of the goals and expectations on this side of the ball for you guys this year?
We really want to pick up where we left off. Last year we only lost 2 senior players, Ricky Holt and DeAndre Drummond. And I'm very confident that the guys that we have coming up can replace them, do a really good job. I think at every position, we have some ballers. Everybody's down, get dirty, play hard. And one of the things that we do well is play tough, play to the whistle, and run to the ball. We're just looking forward to, coming back and leaving where we left off.
Trayvon, tell me a little bit about what it's like to compete in camp. How important is having competition at your position?
At my position, well, it's definitely very important to compete, overall, and that's basically what Coach Mack preaches, especially in the winter. We compete day in and day out, and that's how we get the results that we get at New Hampshire, is by competing every day and just making each other better. But, in my position, it's very important to compete because, at any moment, the next guy is going to be up. So you got to compete to make sure that you're going to be able to perform as best as you can.
Coach, some lethal weapons on the offensive side of the ball, obviously coming back, some of them on the preseason all-conference team. You have the preseason offensive player of the year and Trevor Knight at quarterback returning. Obviously a lot of expectations on that side of the ball going into this season.
And as good as those guys have done for us, the whole key to this, to the offensive side of the ball, is the offensive line.
Mm-hmm.
And I truly believe, we got one senior coming back, Dane Heron, who is going to be one of the leaders of the offensive line, our starting left tackle. I feel very comfortable with Noah Robeson, who started a couple games at the end of the year last year. And our two interior guys were both redshirt freshmen last year, started. One started 11 games, the other started 12 games for us, Jack Carroll and Matt Mashia.
Mm-hmm.
There's some competition, though, with some young kids, which is awesome. It gives us an opportunity to get better. I keep looking at that position as the key. One, we got to run the football, and we get Trayvon back, which is important. Two, we got to be able to protect Trevor so that we can throw the ball to our receivers. And I'm looking forward to seeing how Malik Love, Kieran Presley, and then, of course, Neil O'Connor continue to develop and get better as this summer goes on, and more importantly, as this season goes on.
How important has the development of Trevor Knight been? I mean, talk about kind of, going into the first game last year and then where he is now this year. I mean, he's got to be a whole different young man.
I gave a lot of credit to what Trevor did from 2 years ago in December to where we are right now. He's worked extremely hard in the off season to physically get his body ready to play in at least 11 contests and sometimes more. He's gone to a couple different places to work on his own, and appreciate how he's gone about doing that. He's been healthy, which is important, key, but I also think he's developed an understanding of our offense and our beliefs that he's a distributor. Get the balls to people who can make things happen in open spaces, and he's done a real good job of learning from his redshirt freshman year to sophomore and then last year.
Juwan, what's, you know, the, we talked early in this interview about the playoff streak, and you know, you're going for 15 in a row this year. Is that something that you talk amongst players, maybe like you don't want to be the team that loses that streak, or is it more of just like keeping that confidence, like we're going to keep the expectations, like we're going no matter
what? I think
it's
just a mindset at this point. We know we're going to get to the playoffs. You know, we've done it 15 years straight. And I think it's more of a responsibility as a senior class to make sure that we lead these guys and get them there for another year.
Traylon, what do you like about camp?
What I like about camp?
Yeah,
that's camp. I can't wait to hear that.
Who likes camp? But, the thing that I like about camp is that, you know, you really get to the point to where you create the player that you want to be for that season. And you use that camp time to just really grind and, you know, mold yourself. So when that first game comes, you know, it's game time. And that's one thing I love about camp, because you get the freshmen and they go through the freshman breakdown, and then, you know, being a upperclassman, you get the chance to be a role model for them and help them get through the process, just like how you had to go through growing up. And so it's just it's a good team bonding, and that's one thing that I really like about the camp atmosphere.
How's your recovery been for your knee? I mean, how tough was it to kind of sit on the sidelines and watch last year?
It was tough. I remember going into the first game against UMaine, right before the game, I cried, you know, just noticing the fact that I wasn't going to be able to play that season. And the recovery has been going well. Right now I'm back at 100%. Trainers have been doing very well with me, and strength is coming in well. It's going very good.
Yeah, definitely excited to see you back out there.
You've seen camp change.
Yeah.
I've seen camp change, right? It's a lot different. I don't want to be one of those old guys, you know, talking about how hard it used to be, but I think there's some advantages to the way that we're practicing football now.
I think we're doing it the right way now. You know, recovery is the huge thing. And, you know, we were never a recovery team. We were a grind team. You know, and bringing my beliefs from Coach Bowes and the New Hampshire program about the hard work and stuff like that, now you realize that, you know, you've got to prepare your body for a 12-week season or 14-week season, and you can't grind and kill it in that first 2 or 3 weeks of camp. The single practices are efficient for us to get them done. The walkthroughs have been enable us to teach and coach and do it, and as we say, in a teaching progression, you know, and it's a teach period for us. And I think our kids, it dials them in for what they're doing. And I really appreciate the fact how they've embraced how we're going about doing it. Big thing with special teams too, you know, get a lot of extra work in that area, an area we really got to improve upon. So you're excited about where it's going, I think.
Juwan, it's right off the bat, you're playing for the Musket. Last year, I know that's a little new, playing at week one instead of last week of the season. First of all, how odd was it to play Maine first game of the season? And, you know, what do you guys expect as you head into the, you know, week one right off the bat? You'll be playing for the Bryce Cowell Musket again.
It's a little different. You know, we're used to playing them, you know, towards the end of the season, so you have a lot of film on them. But now it's, you know, first game of the season, they could, you know, bring out a whole bunch of trick plays. You really don't know what to expect down there. But, you know, our guys are always excited. You know, we want to keep the Musket right now. It's in Durham. Hopefully, you know, we want to stay there. But our guys are excited. You know, it's going to be a great atmosphere up in Maine. It's going to be a very electric atmosphere. But it's exciting. It's very exciting.
Does it help going into camp knowing that you're opening up with Maine?
Yeah, it gives you more of an incentive just to work a little bit harder. You know, those are our rivals right there. And, you know, definitely don't want to lose to them.
Right.
Yeah. Do you like it, or do you prefer it at the last game of the year? I mean, it's definitely a tremendous change. I mean, especially such a heated rivalry.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I love it. Whether it was the third, fourth, fifth, it doesn't matter. You know, I love that week. So with it being the first, you know, it turns the intensity up just a little bit quicker, sooner than what we expect. So, yeah, we like it.
Coach Mack, what about you? I mean, it's got to change a little bit.
You know, I love the last game of the year being Maine. I'm not going to lie here, you know, but it's always been in my heart that way. But here's the thing. I was talking to two of the guys from Rhode Island. They're playing an opener against, I think, Delaware or something. Yeah. You know, hey, your antennas are up, man, and you're getting to play in a Thursday night throwdown. Our atmosphere was unbelievable. I know Joey and the Maine people will have that place ready to go. You know, we'd meet them halfway on 95. We had them to play the game. That would be a great thing. We want to keep the Musket where we belong.
All right. Well, gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us here on Media Day. Good luck this season. We look forward to that Thursday throwdown, I believe they're calling it, up there at Maine for week one of the season on that Thursday night. Good luck this season.
Thanks, Bobby. Thanks. We appreciate it, man.